All right. Hi, friends.
Hi, friends.
Hi, friend.
Hi, friends.
This is no longer that sad Giles Ellis.
And this is Shane Lancaster, back again from last week.
God damn it, Levi. You're always supposed to go second, and you always fuck it up. We just talked about it right before the podcast. God damn it, Levi. Fuck
you guys.
Jesus Christ.
Levi's shitty.
Levi's
He's always going to be shitty. If Levi wasn't shitty, he wouldn't be Levi, and he wouldn't be on the podcast.
He always tries to ruin this podcast by forgetting what order we're in. I'm Zach Price.
You have to stop kicking people off the podcast.
Well, it's just Levi. Yeah.
Especially
because
you're low man on the podcast totem pole.
Well, listen. That may be true. Well,
I'm Levi Lancaster since fucking...
No, it's too late, Levi.
Yeah, I know. Obviously. Of course, I gotta ruin everything.
It's fine.
So, as everybody listening knows, well, Muhammad Fassad or whoever you are listening, I wasn't on the last one, but I did listen to it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? What'd you think?
And I fucking hated it because I wasn't on it.
I know.
No, I'm just kidding.
That's what
I
told everybody. You're the heart of the podcast. It's nothing without you. It's a dead, desiccated corpse is what it is.
I listened to it while I was at work, and while doing that, I took notes.
Oh, yeah?
One of those is...
This is the first time hearing about this.
What are you, like a fucking investigator or something?
This is a secret.
Yeah.
You're like a journalist?
Secretly autistic is what the deal is.
I'm not that autistic.
It's a secret autism.
I'm just good at Tetris. So,
so you're secretly Asian.
Yeah, so I might be. Something I learned. Well, my hair is kind of like straw consistency. But something that I learned from the last podcast, well, one of the things, is when you guys were talking about Grindr.
Mm-hmm.
Gay people have it so easy, Zach.
Right?
Are there any more complaints to be had where you're actually running away from dating apps because you're being offered too many blowjobs? Are you serious?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
It's like I said, they have a fuck button.
Kinda like...
Can you imagine how great life would be if you had
a
fuck button?
Oh, you're into men.
Yeah, but
and
I'm
all men
want to
do is fuck. Fucking who cares, dude? You're gonna die anyway.
It might just
oh no, AIDS! But I get
just
AIDS.
Just give
but...
someone a blowjob doesn't mean you have to like fucking gargle that shit.
Would it be bad if everybody in the world had AIDS? if every single person in the world had AIDS, wouldn't it just kind of even itself out?
If everyone has AIDS,
it's like no one has.
No,
AIDS.
I don't. I mean, in a way.
Yep. Yep.
I guess in a way.
It was rhetorical. That is the right answer. Good job, Giles.
Jesus.
Also, something else that I wrote down. You guys mentioned Batman. I forget why and when.
Okay.
Something about his parents being dead. Right? His parents are dead?
Yeah.
Something.
So yeah, right. So that's the thing. Batman's parents are dead, so he's all upset.
Yeah.
Does Batman not have any other relatives?
He's got.
I mean, Shane,
he's got a son now.
Shane would be, but Albert's not a relative. That's more of like.
I mean, he's
not Albert. It's
he's
Alfred. Alfred.
But you're telling me
it's
you're
Alfred.
Telling me Batman.
Alfred.
Batman's whole.
Yeah, why did I say Albert? Yeah, no, Fat Albert. You know, like.
Hey, Batman! You gonna go fight some crime,
Butler?
Shane, fix your mic. It's kind of messing up.
Yeah.
Well, what's wrong with it?
But
you're just cutting.
It keeps cutting up.
Yeah.
But So, Batman, his whole family consisted of just his parents, and when they died, he just had no one. Not a cousin, not an aunt.
He had a
not
bunch
a hot
of money.
Cousin that he would fuck if it wasn't his cousin.
Well, the thing is, he had relatives, but they were black, and so he'd rather not live with them.
Oh. Oh, that solves that.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
yeah, that's
speaking
a good point.
Of,
I guess I've never
speaking
I
of,
looked
like,
into that.
What?
I've never looked into the whole Batman lore of whether he has like extended family. Maybe they're all like racists or something like that, or Scientologists.
Yeah, he can't face the fact that he has to talk to them at Thanksgiving now. But yeah, like going back to, you know, Zach, you were talking about Tinder and Grindr and all that, and how you were running away, and how Tinder.
Well, he was still in high school. Like, what? That freaked me out.
Well, you said Tinder depressed you because you didn't match with the guys that you thought were hot.
Yes, that was also the case. And the ones I did match, because I live in Oklahoma, were all like very religious. Like, I went to this one guy. He like did his Twitter thing, and all of his thing were like Bible posts. And I'm like.
Was well, a lot like of girls DL'd, do that too, okay? But like was they'll have like... scriptures tattooed on their ass.
Was he like the kind of gay where he would fuck you and then be like, and then try and baptize you or something?
He'd fuck me and then
to expel the sin from you.
One of those gay camps.
Oh, he'd dip him in the water, all right. He'd dip him right in the water. But yeah, like you're really not doing Tinder correctly.
Oh, I'm not.
No.
You're supposed to swipe on everybody's picture,
you're supposed
right?
to just, like, watch TV. Yeah, you're supposed to just watch TV or play video games and swipe right endlessly until you run out.
I thought...
And then when you get matches, it's a surprise to see who likes you.
Oh.
That's how you do it as a man. As a woman, you go on and try to build your confidence and be like, oh, he's cute, swipe, match. Oh, he's all right, swipe, match. That's how you do it, because that's how Tinder works. And then you just never meet up. You just kind of talk to them for 10 seconds and ditch it. And that's why Tinder kind of sucks.
I've never actually tried Tinder. Like, I keep telling myself I'm going to do it, but...
You should do it, Shane. I think that would be great.
Giles actively
material.
Tries to get people to not match with him on Tinder through his.
No, I don't.
No, I think he tries to get people to match with him, and then he just fucks with him.
Probably, one of your Tinder buyers, you said that you would hit a woman if she interrupted you playing Rocket League. Like, that was something. You
okay,
said.
Isn't okay, that Rocket isn't League. It better to go into it knowing that information?
And to be fair, Rocket League
you're really not
get
selling
intense.
Like he's selling the true Giles right. experience yeah. but he's not selling right. himself to women.
Isn't that what you're supposed to do? I don't give a fuck. But there was this one chick that I matched with who was like, she called herself like the queen of memes or something like that, and we matched and we talked for a little bit, but again I got bored. But my Tinder profile picture is the picture of me holding a pumpkin over my head.
Yeah.
And my bio is, my parents threw me away when I was born, so I'm just looking for that special dumpster diver with a little heart. And I said, or just swipe right if your boyfriend ain't home. That works too. I don't think that's a bad bio.
See, that's the other thing about that is that I have no idea how
a couple
any
times.
Of this shit works. Like, I don't know how to make a Tinder bio. What do you put in there? Like, long walks on the beach and... being paid
See, the thing
an
is,
asshole.
You need to sell yourself. Yeah. I guess I don't know.
Yeah,
nobody.
The thing is, I'm
okay. Listen, if they haven't swiped and now they're reading your bio, you're pretty much already fucked. Like if they saw your profile picture and they didn't immediately swipe right, and now you're there reading your bio, there's pretty much
it's about the picture.
Yeah, there's really like very little that you can say besides.
I
like,
thought you.
I'm
I thought
rich.
You used the bio as like
or like
a conversation.
I'm down for
or
anal. No, no, no.
Well, I mean, you know, put a bio. Just
you should
so
put
you
a
look
bio. You can't just point. Like leave it blank. But like.
But I'm also in the same boat, Shane, as where it's like, I'm horrible at selling myself because I can't like.
Too honest.
I can't. Yeah, I can't be like, oh, you know, I like playing video games
and horses.
Sometimes I ride my bike and I don't like horses. They give me anxiety. I work at this warehouse in Mansfield, Massachusetts. I feel like explaining yourself like that makes you too vanilla.
The only people that check
Mansfield,
the bio
Massachusetts
like...
sounds like it's the setting of a Stephen King novel.
The only
it can be if they date me.
Other reason that people would check the bio is to make sure that the person that they think is hot didn't say something really weird or creepy. So, just avoid writing something weird and creepy. Like, I don't know, like, I'm going to hit you if you interrupt me kind of thing.
Or maybe
you
want
to
write something
that,
super
isn't that,
weird in
isn't
the bio
that,
to make sure that they've actually read it.
Isn't that obliviously creepy, though? what I was trying to do when I initially put shit like that is find the one woman that exists that has a sense of humor.
Women don't have a sense of humor. That's why you should be gay.
Right, so I guess I'm just going to die a virgin. I'm going to say it. No, I'll say it. I'm a virgin.
You've
I'll say
had
it.
Way too much fucking Craigslist sex to die a virgin. Or no, wait, that wasn't you. That was
that was Edward. That was Edward. Yeah,
that was Edward. That was Edward.
Fuck.
That's how we actually. For those of you who don't know, we don't even really know Edward. We answered one of his ads on Craigslist, and he came on our podcast. And then him and Zach had sex.
He gave
Yes, that's pretty much Edward's thing.
Zach
the whole
was the one that fucking spread his shit all over his shirt.
Yeah, that's me.
We just found Edward outside of a frat house, scooped him up.
He doesn't listen to this. It doesn't matter. We can say anything.
Okay, so this whole Tinder talk.
I'll say anything anyway.
This whole Tinder talk brings me to something that I wanted to ask us all.
Yeah. Go.
Whose fucking brilliant idea was it to take like four people just riddled with depression and try and make like a schedule that they would stick to? For recording podcasts.
Levi, are you depressed?
No, Levi's probably the least depressed of any of us, but like...
I was gonna say, I don't... Levi's the only one that doesn't strike me as depressed.
Yeah, Levi's just this happy-go-lucky fuck sitting on the podcast.
Probably because he has
be
a...
Miserable.
Probably because he has a girlfriend. He has a girlfriend that loves him very much, so...
Yeah.
But yeah, so like...
She's short, though, so.
We try to... We talk to each other like every night and we're like, oh, should we do the podcast? And someone's like, I don't know.
So, like,
I think I'm just gonna sleep
our scheduled
and fucking
time to
not eat for 4 days
is
and then
Sunday.
Eat 6,000 calories.
So far since I've been on the podcast, we've recorded on Sunday one time.
we were on a schedule like 3 times, I think.
Yeah, the first 3 episodes of the podcast.
So really you ruined it.
Hey, listen,
yeah,
we had
way to fuck everything up,
it.
Zach.
I did kind of fuck up this weekend. Like, I had... My birthday was on Tuesday. Yay.
Oh, yeah.
Happy
birthday,
Cass. We don't care as much about you as Levi, apparently.
I'm 22. I had a good birthday. It was nice. I had dinner with my family. That's what I do every year on my birthday.
Where'd you go? What'd you eat?
That's boring. We went to this restaurant called Lucky's.
Lucky's?
Yeah.
What do they serve there?
They serve like gourmet shit. Like...
They serve dicks,
yeah.
Levi.
Dicks?
Who gives a shit what they serve? Did your dad flip out and flip the table over and shit? Because that's the only time I want
to
hear about this shitty dinner.
Levi always asked this.
Would you think it's weird if he took you to like a strip club for your birthday?
Yeah, I think it's weird. I think it'd be weird either because it'd be
they have
a, it'd be,
they have breakfast.
It'd be like.
Breakfast. Yeah, he took you to breakfast.
A, it'd be like a straight strip club, and like my dad knows I'm gay. Or B, I'd be at a gay strip club, which I don't even know if they exist in Tulsa.
With
my dad. Like, no, thank you.
Would you buy your dad
a lot of
dance?
A couple strip clubs. At least one strip club up here has breakfast.
Oh, we have a place called Cloud Nine, and they have this. They have
legs and eggs.
Legs and eggs.
It's legs and eggs, baby.
Legs and eggs, dude.
Giles, are you a big strip club fan?
No, I hate them actually.
I do too. They're weird and
like it's just
super sad.
Yeah, I'm just like, no, like obviously seeing the girls is nice, but I'm kind of desensitized to shit after I've seen like BDSM strangle porn. and then not only that, to have any kind of interaction, you have to waste a lot of money.
That's
so
true.
It's like, I don't know. It's like gambling with no permanent result.
Well, see, that's the other thing is like. If you've ever been in one, watching the guys in there is really weird because
why are you watching the guys? Homo?
No, that's the best part.
No, because you watch them like, and they I don't know if they think
and they get all hard,
game down super hard,
and they get all
or,
like sweaty.
But yeah, they like
just
throw cash at these
so
women,
much.
And they have like certain women that they just fucking absolutely love, and these women like pay them the most passing interest and. They will just fucking open their wallets and dump it out on their face.
No, it really is a sight to see, seeing like grown men who, at least I hope, know for a fact these women don't actually like them, just fall in love and spend all their money. It's funny.
Yeah, it's
hilarious.
It's
no, it is funny. It's also funny watching someone at a casino dump their entire check into it.
Yeah.
I don't see how you wouldn't find that's funny.
Okay. You ever seen those videos
funny,
of people
I mean,
like
comedy is just tragedy plus time, so.
You ever seen those videos of people who are super addicted to gambling and will like not want to step away from a slot machine or something and just shit in the corner or like in their pants.
Yeah.
You've seen videos? What?
Yeah, no. Yeah, really.
Sometimes I feel like I'm on a different internet than you guys.
No, a lot of people, even old people, well, mostly old people, will wear Depends on purpose just so they don't have to get up from their favorite machine.
Oh my god!
Because it's hot. If they're on a winning streak. They're gonna win any second now.
Swear to God.
Except for they're not on a winning streak and they're just dumping money into this machine, probably.
Right, but they're afraid that someone will come and sit down and then roll like 3 times and hit the jackpot. It's like an actual fear they have.
I'm sure they sit there for like 12 hours in their shit too.
12 hours? Are you serious? That is like way too low. You are setting the bar way too
low.
There's a suicide hotline number on every slot machine.
Oh shit. That is,
swear to God. Swear to God.
That is the dark future that we are living in.
Oh my god.
I swear to God.
How did we end up
in
the darkest timeline?
Because people are shitty and they just get addicted to stupid things. Speaking of dark, Zach, when I'm not around, I don't appreciate you telling our listeners that I had a shitty childhood and I was an angry kid. I don't appreciate that because it's false.
You were an unhappy child. One time...
That's false.
One time on 4th of July, to show that you were patriotic, you drew Osama bin Laden dead in a bank vault. That's something you did in fourth grade.
In a bank vault.
Why a bank vault?
I don't know.
I don't know. It was fifth grade. No.
You know, happy children don't draw dead people, even if they are Osama bin Laden.
It was sixth grade, because it happened in fifth grade.
I think a lot of children draw dead people and dumb shit like that.
Yeah, not happy children though.
It was graphic, but I mean, it was like
I think creative children do it.
Well, if I know myself well enough to be able to tap into my childhood, it's like they gave us this project. Okay, here's all these crayons and shit. Color something patriotic. Something in remembrance. It was like in remembrance of 9/11.
I mean, not 9/11.
It was in honor of 9/11.
How old were you?
I was sixth grade.
So that's like 11 or 10.
You were smart.
So it was like
sixth grader.
Like a year after, maybe.
It was 1 year after.
Yeah. Okay.
So draw something. It was like the following year. So it's September, then like the next July. So in remembrance of 9/11.
2002.
Yeah. So in 9/11, the teacher had us just draw something. She's like, draw something to signify how you feel about it. And just like, she was basically telling us to flex our American dicks. And you know for a fact, even at that age, I knew, oh, this is just going to be another bullshit project to get us to draw an American flag or something. And this, it's like, okay, with that being said, these other students got that covered. They have that shit covered. I'm not going to draw another American flag. What a waste of time.
Giles,
so instead you draw
the mangled
corpse
of Osama
bin Laden.
Giles speaks truth to power, okay?
I drew the mangled corpse of Osama bin Laden because fuck him. And teachers, instead of being like, yeah, you know what, fuck them. Which, even if I was crazy, it would become...
Right? They should have put it on the bulletin board outside the school, right?
Well, yeah,
a big
Zach.
Poster,
yeah,
right
because
on the
if,
front of the school.
If I was crazy, if something was wrong with me, which what they were worried about was, then, like, hearing, like, oh, yeah, it would make me, I guess, maybe feel not as alone, which it did. And
why can what's his name make a fucking country song about killing Osama bin Laden, but you can't make a fucking kid
because
drawing.
He's a child.
Well, I think it wasn't just like Osama. I was really good at drawing, and it wasn't just Osama like with X's on his eyes. I'm pretty sure he had like limbs missing, and there was blood and like bones everywhere and shit. And And, like, I think there was an American flag hanging up in the vault. And it's like, instead of seeing that and trying to see the imagery of it and being like, okay, some children are different and aren't afraid.
Yeah, some children are unhappy. And
some children are different.
Express themselves.
And not afraid to express themselves, even though they know they might get backlash, because that's how you make a good artist.
Or that's how you get attention, because you're an unhappy child who needs it.
Fuck you!
Who,
they
listen,
just looked at the picture, they looked at the drawing, and they were like, oh no.
Was this?
No, this was middle school.
No, okay, it was high school
prison. Prison. All right.
This was middle school. I also got in trouble.
This was juvie.
I got in trouble 8th grade for drawing a stick figure with like really big tits and like a fat vagina. it was a stick figure with really big tits and like a prominent vagina.
Giles, and... do you actually remember where you were when you heard about 9/11?
I was in 4th grade. I was in class, but I don't like. It's not like they wheeled in an old TV like everybody says. I just remember them saying it.
They just had TVs in our classroom. I remember walking into like first period and my teacher being like, "Oh, shut up and sit down." And then he turned on the TV, and that was basically. And then we watched it a whole bunch.
I don't remember. I probably wasn't paying attention.
Do you even remember that whole
deal? I gotta be honest. I don't. It happened when I was in first grade. Apparently, my parents talked to me about it, and I didn't. And like, I knew what happened, but I don't have like currently. I don't have a memory of 9/11. It happened during first grade. I remember the first time.
You guys are fucking babies.
I know. I remember the first time I had a thought and like a realization of like what the like significance of 9/11 was. Wasn't until I was like 11, like when I was.
So you don't even remember
9/11? I don't remember 9/11. 2001 9/11. I don't remember.
Investigate 3/11.
Yeah. Shout out to Eric Andre.
I was in fifth grade when 9/11 happened, and I didn't find out until I got home.
Really?
But,
they kept that shit hidden from you?
Well, like, I went throughout the day, and I guess I did notice the teachers talking a little bit, kind of like, you know, like, oh,
I'm pretty sure my teacher was crying.
Really? Well, like,
yeah,
you could tell,
like a fucking
there was
pussy.
A weird vibe throughout the day. It was just like a weird vibe. And then at the end of the day, the principal got on the intercom and was like, you know, like, we kept this shit away from you and, like,
he said
go
shit.
Home and talk to your parents. Yeah, he was like, you guys are
this fucking bullshit.
He's just like,
that
this
happened.
Shit's fucked up,
he's like,
guys.
He's like, we're going to war.
We're
going
to kill
up,
these
motherfuckers.
He put your picture on a projector on
the TV. Yeah. This is the only one fighting for what's right. This is the only kid speaking up.
But yeah, then I got home and our dad was watching it on the news. And that was about 4 o'clock, so it was like late in the afternoon. They've been playing it all day. So my dad's been sitting there watching it probably all day. And like, he didn't really say anything about it. Like, he was just like, yeah, it's
the interesting
up.
Thing is like my mom, she worked at an airport. She still does. She worked at an airport at the time. She still does. And she actually had taken the day off on that particular day for whatever reason, like as a vacation day. So she just sat at home watching it all day. I thought it was.
Well, it's not like she would have had anything much to do since they grounded all the planes. It just would have been a really slow day at work for her.
It would have been a slow day at work. I guess she didn't have to waste one of her vacation days on it.
Your mom caused 9/11.
If she'd have
if
only
she was
been
there,
there,
she
man.
Could have stopped them.
She could have stopped it. She could have stopped it from Tulsa, Oklahoma. She could have stopped 9/11. Shit, dude.
Does anybody have any topics this week?
Shut up.
Shut up,
shut
Levi.
Up.
Will you stop saying that and just segue like a normal person,
yeah.
You freak?
So I don't drink
you
often.
Fucking piece of shit.
I don't drink often. I drank a little on my birthday. I had like 2 drinks and I felt like...
I said shut up.
I have like such a... I have like... So like here's the great thing about like never drinking and like drinking so little.
You're
is that,
a cheap date.
Oh man, it fucking... Yeah, A there. And like B, it like takes like 2 or 3 drinks to get me like... To just get me there.
And you have the
so
mental...
So you're saying you're really easy to date rape?
Yeah, oh yes, totally. Like, completely. You just put like 4 drinks in me, you could probably just do whatever the hell you wanted me to do. I mean, you just, I wouldn't even know.
Why don't you just have a few beers before you go on your Tinder dates then?
Sounds like you're implying that's what you want.
I mean, listen, I'm not saying I don't have rape fantasies.
Boy. Oh, I thought, like, a lot of people have rape fantasies.
Yeah, I think a lot of people do.
I mean,
is your fantasy,
do you just get super hard
raped
when you watch Shawshank Redemption, Zach?
Oh, my fantasy's to be raped, obviously.
Obviously.
By a male guidance counselor.
Is this something that happened during
your
childhood?
Are you sure you didn't
childhood?
Have a really
refreshing
yeah, unhappy childhood?
No, and for the record, no, my dad didn't blow me. That's something you guys asked.
Well, maybe you wish he blew you. That way he knew he'd love you.
Yeah, because nobody was loving me. They were too busy being mad at me for drawing Osama bin Laden dead. You know what I was thinking is, like, I was probably thinking this can go one of two ways. They'll be mad, or I will be looked at as a hero for doing something so brave. Yeah, because I did something so brave by drawing this picture.
Oh my god!
Yeah.
Did you want to be like that guy who tried to go to I can't remember what country it was, Iraq or something like that, with a broadsword so he could kill Osama bin Laden?
Yeah,
that is a real thing that happened. He was like, some crazy dude was stopped at the border with like a broadsword and like other weird weapons, and he
really?
Basically was like, "I'm here to kill Osama."
It's basically like the woman, like it's a modern version. It'd be like that was the past version of like the modern woman saying, "I'm gonna kill ISIS." Like, those motherfuckers
yeah.
better not become
so
here.
So basically,
I'm kill
it was
ass.
Braveheart going after Osama bin Laden.
Yeah.
Yes.
Who do you think would win?
I don't know. Wasn't Osama bin Laden like on fucking dialysis and all
people
sorts of other
on
shit?
What?
Braveheart's the one where there can only be one, right?
No, that's Highlander.
Oh, I thought that was Conan the Barbarian.
No.
What? What? No, that's Arnold Schwarzenegger.
I'm doing our shitty movie thing.
You're doing a shitty human thing.
Us.
Yeah, I'm messing with you,
Zach.
It's not a joke, Zach. That's
I mean, you guys aren't running with my joke. It's a bad joke. I'll admit it. Cut it from the podcast. It's having around 27 minutes.
You're cut from
no.
the podcast.
All right.
I'm serious.
Yeah, okay.
No.
Get off.
No. Get out of here, Zach.
I'm gonna sneak my way into every single podcast. Just you wait.
Yeah, you fucking snuck into this one. We didn't want you on it. let's talk politics.
Oh, fuck
politics.
You.
Let's
yeah.
talk
yeah.
politics.
Talk
about Trump.
Let's
go
see
fuck
if we
yourself.
Can get Zachary to just blow his asshole out again.
I'm already, I'm ready to fucking, Levi said the two stupidest things you could probably say to a gay
that
person
I would have voted for Trump.
That if I would have voted, A, that's one. If I would have voted,
wait, why is that
I
dumb?
Voted?
Stupid.
What, gay people
wait,
are
why,
really,
why is that
really
says
into,
the guy that's...
what, civic duty and making
yeah,
well,
sure cause
people
it just,
vote?
Because, like, it's saying, like, if I would have voted, it means that, like, I have no investment in politics. Like, I don't give a fuck about politics. So that's one thing to start a political discussion by
true.
Starting to say, if I would have voted. That's a fucking
true.
Dumb thing to say.
You don't know
that,
I'm not
yeah,
going to
start.
Not
true.
Yeah,
you
don't
do. You don't know
start.
If he's into politics
yeah.
or not.
I know yeah. he's not into politics because he didn't vote. Anybody who's into politics votes. Giles, do you that's... vote?
You can't use me as an example.
Giles, do you vote? I know the answer to this. It's no, you don't vote. Do
Shane,
you care about
you
politics?
Vote?
No, you don't.
Yeah, of course I voted.
Are
yeah.
you into politics a lot, though? I guess you would be probably.
He knew about Bernie
like,
Sanders.
I kept up with
well,
what was
I knew
going
about
on
Bernie
to the,
Sanders.
With the election to a certain extent, and I knew I wasn't going to vote for either of the two main candidates.
If there were two dogs running against each other, I'd vote. So
I mean,
does that mean I'm into politics?
No.
Yes.
How? Yeah. If there, because there has actually been like candidates that have been animals.
Yeah,
in
there's a
in
governor.
What
is
fucking
that
universe?
Politics?
No, there's a governor.
And they've won. Yeah, there's like
there's a governor.
There's a governor in like.
There is a mayor that is a dog. I will.
Mayor. A mayor, yeah.
So
his name's Duke.
Politics?
There's a dog mayor. No, well, it's a mayor. What does a mayor do? Nothing.
Well, I'm into politics because I'm a Duke for president.
Marmaduke for president? I like Marley for president.
Also, you guys said not voting is voting. I genuinely think that's bullshit.
You think that's bullshit? You think not voting?
Yeah, I do
same,
too.
I think it's the same as voting. I think it's the same as voting for as the.
I think it would be the same as just going in and voting for both people.
And no, it's not actually. It's voting for the majority.
No one
not
in
voting.
Office. That's what I would do. But I don't have that choice.
The not voting is voting for the majority. It's like saying, like, whatever the majority decides, that's what I want. That's what not voting says. That's why it's the same as voting.
No, not voting is me being too wrapped up in my pizza rolls.
I mean, not voting is also just, like, not...
To be fair, pizza rolls are super delicious.
Which is your decision. Like,
I could see how that could happen.
We're talking too much. Why did you bring up pod? Why did you bring up politics, Giles? This is your fault.
You don't know that I don't go out and like.
Listen, if Mr. Totino ran for president,
Totino's.
If Mr. Totino ran for president, would you vote for him, Giles?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Mr. Totino pretty much did.
I say Putin for president.
I mean, you got him.
Not my president. Not my president.
I don't know. That whole thing was pretty crazy.
I don't know. I saw Trump talking when I was at the gym, and I just thought it was kind of funny. No, he was on TV. Sorry.
Speaking of politics, have you guys seen the whole thing about how Russia is blackmailing Trump because he had a bunch
of
women piss on a bed?
Pissing on him?
That's fake news.
It is, but like, dude, it's awesome.
Honestly, I think it's real. And they...
here's the sentence Levi just said.
He never really did... No, like,
Levi, pause for a second. Here's the sentence you just said. That's fake news. I think it's real.
But if you listen to actually like what the response to Donald Trump, he kind of doesn't really deny it. He kind of just avoids it like he does with everything.
You can't
I think Trump would immediately jump on that thing. I think he'd be like, "Yeah, got a bunch of
Trump has
super
a fat
hot hookers.
Dick.
I grabbed him by the pussy, dragged him back to my room and just fucking had him go full blast all over that bed."
Trump has a fat dick, and that's why Zach's mad.
I hate people with fat dicks now.
Yep. They make you run away from Grindr.
It's Tinder.
Go on Grindr one day.
I should.
With me right there, I want to see it.
Okay.
We should have
go
you go
on Grindr and see how many
I'll go on
Grindr. You can get,
I'll make
Zach.
A Grindr account right now. I'll download Grindr right now.
Does it have a good user interface?
I have no fucking clue. I've never had a Grindr. I'm downloading it right now.
I thought you did have a Grindr.
No, I said I should get a Grindr. I had a Tinder and I deleted it. I never had a Grindr. I'm downloading it right now. That'll keep the audience interested, Giles.
Yeah, Giles!
You know what will definitely keep the audience interested? You mentioning that the audience isn't going to be interested every fucking podcast, Zach.
Zach, why are you trying to
every
destroy
goddamn
the podcast?
He's being so self-deprecating all the time.
Well, that's just...
Oh, hey, guys.
Well,
so, guys,
that's that
I
whole thing
I
Zach, said
you hate
about,
yourself.
Like, having three people just fucking riddled with depression. I mean, yeah, I know fucking... I'm no stranger to just contemplating headbutting a fucking railroad spike on a daily basis.
It's like, oh, hey, guys, so what I had for dinner today, oh, yeah, good listen.
I'm not wrong.
Well, it's like... Not, it's like
Zach, let the fucking conversation unfold naturally. Like, you don't know where the conversation is going to take us. It could start off with, I don't know, pizza
places. Yeah, just
places,
shut up.
You also shit
shut
on.
Shut up and listen. Sip.
Giles,
sip
you did that this
Mason
podcast,
jar.
Giles. You did that this podcast. I don't know if you realize. You did that earlier when Levi made a shitty comment about where I ate. You
hey,
did that,
no.
Giles. So don't
shitting
you
on Levi
fucking
is
fucking
yeah,
always
but I,
okay
I cut it off
podcast.
When it.
That's what
if
I always
cut
on
off,
Levi on this podcast. We might as well just quit now.
I cut
Listen,
it off when it
I've
got boring, not before
time.
It got boring.
When I bring
I cut it off when it got boring, not before. Okay? Cunt. So sit there and drink from your mason jar, your fucking hard cider, and keep getting rowdy, and I will fucking get a plane ticket and beat your ass. You hear me?
Yeah,
and it will be a hate crime
jar,
because...
You goddamn hipster.
It will be a hate crime because I don't like the gays, Zach. I don't like the gays. Just kidding.
I'm pretty indifferent to them. I've been to a gay bar a couple of times. It was all right.
I go to a gay bar a few times a month.
I've been to
When I was in school in Iowa City, they had a gay bar there. And I had a friend who was just the biggest lesbian. So she drugged me there a couple of times. What?
You mean like big in stature?
No, it was actually like super tiny. I could fit her in my pocket, but she just loved vagina.
What does that mean?
We would high five about how much we both love vagina sometimes. she took me there. And I remember there being a guy who was wearing nothing but a banana hammock covered in glitter. He was running around getting dollar bills from people, so he would and just throw his cock at their legs and stuff. I gave the guy a dollar. I didn't give a shit. I was like, no, I'm good on the cock, but here's a dollar.
Yeah, there's a gay bar down here that's like after 12, all the straight people go because all the other bars are closed earlier than that one. So I usually go, like, a couple times a month. I haven't gone in a while, though.
I didn't try and pick up women there, but I think it would totally be possible, because it's riddled with, like, gay dudes and fag hags. And they just,
Fag hags are women that,
just collect gay people like their Pokemon cards?
Collect people?
Yeah.
What? Yeah. Wait, there's people like that?
Yeah, there are people like that.
What do you mean?
They just have this big circle of gay friends.
There's like fag hags are people that their only friends are gay people.
Fag hags.
That's
what
they're
called. Do they fight the gays? Like do they just do they turn?
Yes, it's exactly like Pokemon.
Like it's dog fighting.
They're all like glitter poof. I choose you. Use.
I'm gonna drive all of my friends away except for Zach, so I can be considered a fag hag.
No, I think you got to be a woman to be a fag hag. If you're a dude and you only have gay friends, you're just in the closet.
I'd be a fag dad.
Here we go. Download a grinder.
Zach's got a grinder. Good for you, Zach.
Put my picture up. See how many.
One of these guys' names is cum, spelled C-U-M, fuck, spelled F-U-K, me. That's what this
already?
Guy's name is. Cum, fuck,
already?
Me.
You should message him, Zach.
That's what this guy's name is. And he's. How close to me is he?
He's next door.
He is here. He's in your room.
489 feet away from me.
He's. You follow the trail that goes into your dad's room.
It's a little over half a mile.
I'm scared.
That's out of your like zone, though. I know you don't travel that far. You'd have to like pack a day bag or something to make it that far.
Is it? I don't know if this guy, if it's his profile name or if it's just like if you can just put like a status. But his name is called Hot Tub Knight. With a question.
Hot Tub Knight.
Wait, is it Knight? Because then that guy.
That's what I thought. That's what I thought.
I just imagine a dude getting into a big fucking hot tub covered in armor.
Hot tub
like
knight.
Wielding an axe.
No, he's got a lance, and the lance is his dick.
Can I get a cock picture?
What?
I just like.
Yeah, that's what I said. You should see how many
dick
pics
you can get.
I got these
like dude tummy. Like I got this like picture of a
dude tummy.
And like
dude
but, like,
tummy.
I think I have to like.
Is that gay vernacular?
Can we go on record as the saying, tummy has to be the gayest word you can say. Tummy. Oh, I hate the word tummy. I hate when guys use the word tummy.
See, six times the guys to upgrade. How much does it cost to upgrade?
Tummy and yummy. Oh,
man, it's like
Ooh,
a monthly service now. It's called Grindr Extra. I didn't know about this. I get to see six times the guys, six times the possibilities.
I thought Grindr Extra was they would just send dicks to you.
Is this where they hide all the twinks?
Like,
where
through
are
the
all
mail.
The twinks? All I'm seeing are, like, hunks.
What would you prefer, Zach? A twink?
Yeah. Give me a twink. Yeah. Either that or some, like, really hot, like, muscular
you
dude
like...
that didn't care that I'm fat.
So, Zach, you just want, like, some tiny dude that you can throw around the bedroom?
I don't know.
Are you
know.
Sure this isn't
Shane,
why you work at the high
up.
School?
This guy's name is DTF? Question mark.
Are you Zach?
I don't. Yeah, I like this. I like this. I like the service already. Ooh, this guy's cute.
Shane, your mic's still being a little weird. Try to like hang up Skype.
Are you
and
sure
call
it's not?
Back,
yeah,
but just don't
okay,
say
I'll
anything.
Hang up
just don't say anything into Audacity.
Okay.
Yeah. So. So do you think, Shane's on Grindr, that's why he's pretending his microphone isn't working. He went and downloaded it.
I don't know. That's what I hate. Like, I don't know which one of these. Like, this guy had two fake
like,
pictures.
Let me see.
And one of them is good looking, the other one's kind of average. And, like, I'd be.
The down. One with black hair is average?
Well, they're both. Yeah, I'd.
The one on the one on your left right now is average.
Okay, this
Zach,
this one,
maybe you
this
should just
good
lower
looking
your standards
with a bad
a
haircut,
bit.
And this one like has a good haircut, but he looks average. This is
Zach.
Gay
just
people.
Lower your standards,
is,
and then you could fuck.
He
every
is
day.
1 mile away from me. He's 1 mile away from me.
Go get him, dude. It's
Zach,
so fucking
you just need
easy
to go get
to
laid.
Gay.
Yeah.
It's so fucking easy to be gay.
Ooh, this guy squinting.
Yeah, didn't you say all gay people squint?
What?
He did. He said about Jaden Smith. I was like, Jaden Smith is gay. He's like, is that why he's always squinting?
That's right. That was the weirdest, like,
That's the weirdest the racist
stereotype
moment I've,
of,
ever.
I've ever heard. Yeah.
From a gay guy.
Racist. I mean, moment. Like, show me a gay person that doesn't squint.
You
get it, Neil. I squint all the time. Every all the time.
Is it because you
let
don't go outside?
Neil Patrick Harris. Let's go, Neil Patrick Harris. Bet you first photo I get of him. He's squinting in it. He's doing the squint. He's doing.
Why
he's
do
not
they
like
all
squinting?
Squint?
But he's.
I
squinting.
Have to squint, but that's because my future is too bright.
He's got squinting photos. Give me another gay person.
Yeah, okay.
Let's see if that works for lesbian Ellen DeGeneres.
Another gay person?
Yes, look for a lesbian. She's not squinting. It's only gay males.
Eazy-E.
Is Eazy-E gay?
Who is Eazy-E?
You don't know who Eazy-E is?
No.
From NWA? You fuck you.
Is he gay?
Yeah, wow. he died of AIDS.
He's wearing sunglasses. I can't tell if he's squinting or not.
he always wears sunglasses.
He's wearing
that's
sunglasses.
Why he wears the sunglasses.
Yeah, so people won't know he's squinting. Gay because he's always squinting.
Oh no, Easy E. And he died of AIDS, so they all know.
Oh god.
Just Magic Johnson, he's gay.
Magic Johnson. Here's the real test, Magic Johnson. Listen, I already knew who I wanted. Images. Is he squinting? No. Wide-eyed. He's not gay.
He doesn't
gay.
Have this.
He's gotta be gay.
He has. Just because
Zach,
you have AIDS.
Is this seriously a real thing?
No. Yeah, no, it's not. I mean, it might be.
I don't know. You seem pretty convinced. And you have
is
me
that,
convinced.
Is that how
all
the
these guys
actually
are squinting.
Works? You just look for somebody squinting?
Yeah, like, just, it's people squinting.
Look at this.
Are all Asian people gay?
Shit.
I mean,
probably
all,
a little bit.
They're not in squint, though. That's just how their fucking eyes are.
Filtered.
You know what Mike says? You know what Mike says about Asian people?
What?
He said the reason their eyes are like that is because when the Hiroshima bomb went off, they looked too close at the explosion.
Jesus Christ.
He said that's why they're in permanent squint. Because when the bomb went off, they were just all staring at it. Oh, no.
It's
holy
so
shit.
So beautiful.
Holy shit.
Okay, as far as ways to die go, I think being blown up by an atomic bomb and leaving a fucking shadow on a wall forever. Not exactly the worst way to go.
No. Or being like, covered in volcanic metal. Ash.
I think,
being
yeah,
being covered
cool.
in volcanic
yeah,
ash
into a,
while you're
turned into
doing
a fucking
cool.
human statue.
This yeah, like I want to get covered in volcanic ash while I'm fucking.
I got a notification.
So everyone can see my bad form forever.
I just want to say that the guy with the username called Come Fuck Me, he looks like Vin Diesel.
I'm go get it. Don't you love
Vin
Diesel?
Yeah, go get that, man.
I do love
yeah, for
I
real,
do
yeah.
love Vin Diesel. I may message him.
Edward hates Vin Diesel. I forgot to ask him why.
Zach,
Edward likes Shen
Nu go fuck somebody.
And hates Vin Diesel. He can go fuck himself.
Don't talk about my Ed that way. You're off the podcast.
Okay.
Vin Diesel's awesome. He plays D&D like a huge nerd.
Listen, I love Vin Diesel.
Oh, I hate... Who else tried to do that? Fucking Ronda Rousey. Oh, look at me working out in a Pikachu costume. I'm a nerd. Like, you can relate to me. Shut up, you fucking manly bitch. I'm glad she sucks now.
Well, especially now that they're just letting any dude in there.
Why can't I just see all the guys I want to see? Why do I...
I don't know. Nunez beat her
Zach.
Ass. It was
Zach.
Awful.
Zach.
Yeah?
This makes for great podcasting.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, get off Grindr, you faggot.
You want to call me on Grindr? Why do I have to pay to see more people for Grindr? I thought
because it's basically prostitution.
Money. That's how you make money off of the gay man.
Yeah. Zach, just go on Backpage.
Pink 20.
That and Poppers.
What is what go on what?
Backpage.
Isn't that like... the one that just got caught for like prostitution or something like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, Backpage is basically. Just Craigslist for prostitution.
Well, I'm gonna Google
and they
that
got,
right now.
Yeah, they got
Giles is
for
furiously hitting his keyboard
recently.
At the moment. You guys can't see it, but yeah, he's already on Backpage.
Oh, yeah, I already got on. I already got on and off.
I get it. Would you ever get a hook, Giles?
I was there.
Would I?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't. Why not?
Giles would do anything for the story. Giles once said that he would fuck a woman who was pegging me while she was blindfolded, and he's only talking to me. Just for the story.
Yeah. I want.
I was blindfolded.
I want a woman to fuck Zach in
yes.
the ass
while I'm blindfolded.
While I'm fucking her, probably in her ass because her vagina's covered up by the strap-on.
Yes.
And to make it realistic for Zach, he'll be blindfolded, and I'll talk to him as if it's my dick,
and,
but it's not.
And the girl can't talk. She's not allowed to say
anything. Would that work for you, Zach?
I'd do it for the story.
It would work for me because the girl can't talk.
But I get to talk to Giles, and Giles gets to talk to me.
Yeah, you can talk to me,
like
but
what,
regularly.
Just about the weather?
You can't make
or...
any...
What would you say, Giles?
Yeah, just small talk. Like,
hi.
Just small, like what the weather and stuff like that. Like,
yeah. Hey,
that's
Zach.
How we're doing the next podcast. You two have to be fucking. Yeah.
I just feel like, hey Zach, what's going on? And I'd shoot him some finger guns, then
but I wouldn't know because I'm blindfolded.
The finger guns.
Yeah,
he'd make the noise though. He'd make the noise so I'd know. He'd go pew pew.
I'd be like, yeah. You just hear, hey Zach. Pew, pew.
I'd know. Those are the finger guns. He's giving me finger guns.
And then right when I did the finger guns, he'd come. Because how do you not come when someone does finger guns? Also,
give that chick the finger
it better
guns
be,
in the pussy.
It better be natural conversation, because if Zach makes moans of passion, I won't be able to stay hard enough to fuck the woman.
I don't know, you might realize something about yourself. It might be like an awakening moment, like you coming out of your pupa.
Giles throws the woman off of you and then fucking starts fucking you himself.
The thing is, I'm blindfolded, I would have no idea.
I'm pretty sure you could probably tell the difference between a fleshy dick
I don't know,
and a rubbery
dude, technology.
Oh, I think you
dude.
Would probably notice the sound of... some poor woman's skull
have we
cracking
mentioned...
against the headboard.
Did we mention that the strap-on's going to be a replica of Giles' dick?
And yeah.
It's going to be heated up, so it's going to feel real.
And also, he'll be able to hear me say, oh my god, I love you.
Yeah.
as I passionately
yeah.
thrust.
Did you guys ever do the whole mold of your dick just to have it? Just to be like, huh, so that's what it looks like from the other side.
Wait, what?
Would you ever do the mold of your dick just to have it and be like, huh, so that's what it looks like?
I can look at my dick. I can look at the underside of my dick.
Like, yeah, I suppose you gotta get a mirror or everything, but you don't really get that whole, like fucking head-on coming straight for you view.
Buy a mirror. Buy a mirror.
Yeah, but Shane is so trying to tell us he's gay because he wants to hold a dick. He just wants to hold my own dick. A dick that's not attached to his body is what he's telling us.
No, he wants to grab and hold a dick
that's not attached to his body.
He dresses up his dick in like sweatshirts like it's a pet.
I would do that. Dude, that would be awesome. I'd fucking glue some googly eyes on that shit.
Oh no! He buys a fucking mold of his dick, carries it around.
I'd put it in a Mr. Rogers sweater,
just so we can get a good look at it.
Put it in like
so he can get a good, nice look at his own cock. Like what the fuck?
Yeah, I'd put my dick in a
Mr.
Rogers sweater.
Totally gay.
Fucking glue some googly eyes on there.
There's no way you just be like.
I'd just be like, welcome to my neighborhood.
It's not attached to you. Just like look at it from every angle. You're a faggot, Shane. That's what you are. We broke John.
I mean, if it's good to be best friends with your dick, I don't want to be straight.
We've already established that masturbation is gay, so yes.
No, masturbation is incest. It's not gay.
It's also gay.
Shane. Oh no! Are you gay?
Like I could just imagine him, just that's his only friend. He carries it around.
Giles, are you crying?
Yeah,
right now?
my Giles is going to be my Wilson.
It's not even. It's not even a gay thing. It's just like it's his only friend. He puts googly eyes on a mold of his dick, and he realizes he doesn't need anyone else. At what point would he look at the dick and realize he doesn't need anybody? Like, this is just so perfect.
It's just me and you, dick, against the world.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh god.
And Zach calling you gay.
You see, the terrible thing about that is I'd probably start hearing voices from it, and I'd end up on a clock tower with my dick just being like, take the shot! Take the shot!
It starts a fight club.
What would you name your dick?
Peter.
Peter? I do have a name for my dick, but I don't think it would work if like I actually made a mold of it and tried to make it my friend.
Yeah, this isn't
my
your
dick. The Thunderdome.
The Thunder what?
Welcome to
the Thunderdome,
bitch.
What's your dick's nickname?
Because it's got.
I think Giles literally.
This is two podcasts in a row that I've broken Levi.
You calling him gay and describing what he said, it was just too funny. Like, you really want to just see a dick up close.
You wanted Shane to be gay.
Listen,
fuck it, Zach. Come to Iowa. I'll kiss you up real good. Zach, if you come to Iowa, I will kiss you up so good. I'll put my tongue in your navel. I don't give a shit.
It's all out, dude.
I don't think Giles wants to go to the Midwest ever again.
Midwest sucks, dude. I don't know how you guys live there. I was watching a documentary on prison.
Oh, yeah?
And
to remind you of high school?
Yeah. Like, the most insane prisons, like, mentally insane, is, like, Iowa and North Dakota.
Yeah, Iowa's got one of the worst prisons.
That's what it is. It's like 70% of the population is mentally insane.
What? Oh, really? I didn't know that. I know it's got,
that's
like,
because
of,
all
like,
of
the
their
hardest.
Inmates are just riddled with meth addiction.
Yeah, pretty
that
much.
That shit makes you go crazy.
In Oklahoma.
Like, I was trying to figure out, like, what makes it so, like, just because they live in a certain area, most people are crazy over there.
Yeah,
is it like, yeah, the drugs?
The drugs, yeah.
So,
yeah,
okay,
meth kills you slowly.
Me and Levi's hometown is, like, just riddled with meth.
I wouldn't say it's the worst, but it's definitely, like, it's not the greatest place to live, you know?
Dude, you can go out, like, on a summer night, you can just go out and watch meth heads skittering around town.
Yeah, you can definitely see that, yeah.
Dude, a crackhead ran up to my car today.
Oh, yeah?
Well, not, the, she didn't get to it.
Because you ran her over?
No, I went... I went to the bank.
She was standing in the park and popped the curb.
She wasn't even running after my car. But she I was just getting money out and I was looking both ways to drive out and I looked like her way three times and it must have pissed her off and she went full sprint toward my car. And then when I pulled away like 5 feet from her, she stopped. She stopped running. So it was. She was definitely running after me. But yeah, fucking. As far as like you know, North Dakota and all the meth and shit, I feel like backwater areas are just bad places to raise children because there's nothing to do.
I mean,
yeah, I mean, I don't, notice. I don't, I don't know no, for a fact. Okay, I don't, so
I was gonna say about my hometown, like the place that I'm working at now. I was talking to a guy and he's like, oh yeah, I used to have a boss that lived up in Mason City. And the first question I asked him was he addicted to meth? And he's like, he was! He was the biggest meth head!
That's Oklahoma hilarious. Has a really big problem with meth, but, like, you know, I have a friend whose, like, neighbor's house burned down because they were cooking meth in it, but, like, I never, like, you don't run into a lot of meth heads. They usually stay in North Tulsa, so we're pretty good in the metro area.
But, yeah, all you see over here is, like, heroin addicts. They're not dangerous or anything. They're just, like, sleepy.
Sleepy. Apparently. See, the thing is, like, meth kills you slowly, and heroin, that's why, like, you know, we have meth heads in prisons. And heroin addicts, they, like, they're sleepy.
Just
they don't
end up dead in their apartment.
Yeah, they don't cause a lot of ruckus like meth heads do, and then they just die suddenly from an overdose. So, you know.
Apparently, heroin is making a huge comeback lately.
Oh, yeah, dude. It's like Justin Timberlake bringing sexy back.
Well, heroin made a comeback fucking like 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Well, okay, I mean, so apparently what it was like...
Who lives in like a terrible... Like, he lives in the area, like the state that has the worst heroin problem in the country.
Maryland? Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Massachusetts has the entire New England area.
Oh, yeah, Massachusetts, not Maryland.
Yeah, Massachusetts.
No, I do not live in Maryland.
All I know is that it's upper east side, and it starts.
I mean, yeah, like basically all New England has like this terrible. It's just like a heroin epidemic over there.
Well, you know why that started, right? It's because like they prescribed painkillers forever with reckless abandon.
That is how
it started. You get painkillers. You get painkillers. Just shove them up your dickhole. Who cares?
I was watching a documentary on Mickey Ward, and he fucking, his brother Dickie, I think.
We got brothers named Mickey
and
Dickie
Ward.
Yeah, Mickey Ward is a boxer, a famous boxer.
I didn't know that. I don't know.
How pissed would you be if your brother's name was Mickey and you ended up with Dickie?
Dickie.
Yeah, Dickie.
Probably
Dickie
why he was
a
Dickie.
Fuck you, mom and dad, Dickie.
Dickie was an addict.
Ricky, maybe.
Yeah, really. Dickie, you fucking whore. Watch this. I'm gonna go do heroin. Where Chris grew up, actually not even grew up, one of the places he lived, when we went to visit him, Childress, I think. Yeah, Childress. Childress, Texas. One of his girlfriend at the time, her friend was like, yeah, I've tried meth. It's just, you know, something we did once. While, like, over here, it's usually like, oh, you know, you try weed or, you know, people drink. Like, oh, no, we tried meth just because there's nothing to do.
In Mason City,
I mean, that's
kind of
how
like
it is in Mason, yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say, in Mason City, it's, like, common knowledge that, like, you either like meth or you don't. Because like, everyone does it.
Oh, I feel like
tried
it?
You either like meth or you haven't tried it.
You
no,
because like
some people go, yeah, I tried meth and I didn't like it. But, like, everyone's tried it at least.
Have
once.
You guys tried it?
I've never tried meth.
So no, not everyone.
Don't say everyone.
So, okay, one of the biggest reasons that I've never tried meth is that I used to work with one of the biggest meth heads I've ever seen. He was called Terry the Meth Head Janitor.
Oh, okay.
That's what everybody called him.
That was on his birth certificate.
Might as well have been. But I once walked in on him when he was in his like little janitor closet and watched him just fucking boot up meth into fuck, where was it? It wasn't his arm. I think it was like on his leg or something like that, and it grossed me the fuck out.
Injecting meth?
Yeah, that's how you do it.
How do you just smoke the shit?
Yeah, you can smoke it or shoot it up.
Inject it.
I guess crystal meth is like what's popular here in Oklahoma, and you just smoke that shit.
Most
I didn't know you could inject
it, yeah.
meth. I'm clueless apparently.
But yeah, he was actually a really nice guy, and I liked talking to him and stuff. But he would come to work with scabs on his face and be like, "Huh, long weekend, huh?" Be like, "Yeah, I didn't sleep a whole bunch."
Oh,
this was at Cinema 5. This is at the movie theater.
Oh, at the movie theater.
Great.
Yeah.
Well,
the movie theater I got Levi rested at.
Yeah.
Shoutouts.
Shoutouts.
That's the fucking crackhead meth head janitor.
Yeah. Shoutouts.
Did you guys know any? Did you guys know any drug addicts?
Oh, everybody in my family.
Are they? Do they?
Shout out to them.
Heroin.
Shout out to my family.
No. Well, my family's pills. I mean, I'm sure they've tried heroin. I have a cousin who's really fucked. I'm sure she does heroin or something.
Nah, I'm pretty...
She like, doesn't have teeth.
Oh, nice. No, my family...
Shout out to her teeth.
My family's pretty straight-laced.
She might do meth, actually,
family.
If she doesn't
and
have
I don't
any
really
teeth.
Have... I don't really know anybody.
It could be anything.
I know, like, a few people that have done cocaine before, but that's not even, like...
Cocaine... Zach, you can tell you've never done a drug in your life.
Dude, I've never. I've,
just by the way you pronounce
cocaine.
I mean, I've done cocaine.
Like, cocaine.
I know someone who's banged a rail. a lot of my friends have done coke. And I've even seen them do
gorilla
coke.
Fingers.
It's like drugs up here, like drugs like coke and like pills. And a lot of my friends take Xanax just to do it or fucking.
That's pretty much weed. Over here.
Oh, they'll snort coke at like parties. But it's not like I have some friends who well I mean they're not really friends anymore, but people that I knew that are addicted to drugs now. A lot of girls
know.
That you think are hot in high school end up being fucking terrible looking cuz of drugs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The reason
that's
they're
true.
Hot in high school is cuz they like you know they're basically fucked up their body at a young age because of drugs. I got
yeah.
them looking back, just so they look like 22 when they're fucking 16. And when they're 22, they look 48. So.
I don't know. Ecstasy was really popular in Iowa for a while. That one was weird. There was some dude that
yeah,
ate so much
ecstasy.
That he went crazy because he had holes in his brains and then he killed a
I
bunch
mean,
of people.
Wow, that's awesome.
Oh, shit.
Cool.
Really?
You ever,
yeah, yeah,
okay,
was...
so hold on. I have
no idea.
I have a question that I feel like is interesting.
Oh, yeah?
Why is it that, you know, when, like, people go crazy, it's almost always their first instinct is to kill people.
Not, they don't like...
Isn't that...
I don't think... Well, remember that Kony 2012 guy? He went crazy and didn't instantly kill people. He went...
He just, yeah, he just jerked off on a bus.
Yeah, jerked off on a bus.
Yeah, I guess, but like mostly, you know.
I guess it's just
well, because I think up until the point where you start killing people, people are just like, oh, maybe he's just a really weird
yeah,
guy.
Just lock him away somewhere, fucking like let his family take care of it.
Maybe yeah, maybe it's just like the feeling of being shunned from society, so like you're just detached and you become an animal again.
Yeah, maybe. so like back to me on like drugs.
So you're saying that like being. Right. Isolated makes you a furry.
Yeah,
dude.
Yeah.
ASFO.
ASFO.
Giles
yeah,
and I went on
become
like
an animal again.
Giles and I went on this adventure. We did this like experiment on Omegle. Omegle, you can like type in like common interests, and so we tried to find one that was like common, but like not super common.
For the record, we didn't go on cam. It was the text chat.
No, it was
chat.
The text chat because you can do it. Because I didn't want to meet whatever the fuck I was chatting. So we tried to do like.
Because Zach was too scared.
I was fucking.
Yeah,
it freaked
he
me
was.
Out. It freaked me out.
I was like, let's go find some fucking weird people.
No.
No.
No, I'm scared. No.
What's
so,
the worst thing you'll see? A dick?
Yeah. Well.
You like that shit?
A vagina, dude. And.
You won't
and
see
so
any of that.
We tried
you won't
to,
see any.
we tried to find each other by like searching like these terms that we thought like maybe weren't super popular, but like, you know, had some people in it. That I first tried like Shrek the movie, I got no matches. So I knew that one wasn't gonna work. And so then we typed in furries. That, and both of us, Giles and I, we typed it in, entered it at the same time, immediately got this acronym, ASFO.
And it's like ASL, but I forget what it was.
I remember, but at the time it was like, this is the first time in a long time I've come across something on the internet that's super, like, that's apparently common, that I have no clue what it stands for. So it freaked me out. So I Googled it. It stands for age, sex, persona, fursona, orientation. Fursona. Yeah, so like, you could say like, 14, male dragon, gay. That would be your ASFO.
You would be a 14-year-old
male dragon. I'm be 14.
And you're also gay.
Male dragon. Yeah.
Is that what you are, Zach? Do you have like some art that you want to show us?
He's not 14.
That's your furry animal. Shane, what would your furry animal be?
It's not a lot of fur.
ASFO. I'm going to go with...
Can I just be Tails from Sonic?
No.
I just want to be Tails from Sonic. You kind of look like
no.
An armadillo.
No.
Let me be Tails
I
from
look
Sonic.
Like an armadillo.
Can I say, for my persona, can I be
Shane,
Miles
be
Tails Prower from Sonic too?
I mean,
you
probably
have
could.
A bald head.
Yeah. I just want to be Miles Tails Prower.
I would be Hooch from Turner and Hooch.
Are you disappointed that there's no rule 34 of Turner and Hooch?
I feel like if we do enough call-outs to the last podcast...
I'm not disappointed, and I'm not surprised either, because it's a wholesome family movie. And it's the most amazing movie, and no one should taint it.
I feel like if we do enough shout-outs to the last podcast, those two fucking bastards that didn't listen to it because Giles was in it would not be forced to go back and listen to it.
Why don't you stop hating on our fans?
Listen,
because without them, without them, we're nothing.
Zach just doesn't like people from the Middle East, is what it is.
and my friends,
people.
He doesn't like my friends. Yeah, someone told my friend Jeff that he's like, yeah. So I listened to the last podcast. I heard that Giles wasn't on it, and I turned it off immediately. Which isn't funny. You don't do that. That's not okay. Pay attention to my friends and you enjoy them. I know it's a little hard and they're kind of fucking weird, but listen, you really gotta pull through.
Can I just...
I wanted to dress my dick up as my best friend, so...
Yeah, I'm
gonna do the rest. I thought it was a...
People are weird thing.
I thought it was a good episode.
I'm gonna do the rest of the podcast as Miles Tails Prower from Sonic 2.
Well, hey, Sonic, boo! Hey Sonic, you want to touch my two penises?
I'm gonna do.
Do you think
the
Tails
next...
have two dicks? Oh, how awesome would that be, dude?
I'm gonna do the next podcast as Tails impersonating Zach.
Okay. I can get done with that. You already have
we're
a
getting
Zach
way too
impersonation.
We're getting way too
fucking
meta here.
Gay. I'm fucking gay. I'm fucking gay.
Yeah, that's me.
That's my impression.
That's Giles' impersonation of me. He has this whole voice of when he starts saying shit.
Oh no! I feel it. Oh no! Why would you do that?
Just for the record, audience, thing... that was Giles talking right there.
Yeah.
In case
uncanny.
You couldn't tell.
Uncanny.
It's like there's
fucking...
two of you.
Another thing that made me die laughing was Zach flipped out. Some girl tried to convince Zach that borrowing your friend's underwear is normal.
Yeah, she was talking about this Cosmo thing. It was like tips for the going to your next sex party, and they were like, get new underwear by like borrowing it from a friend. And she like totally glossed over that borrowing thing, and I would not let it go.
Zach's like,
fucking...
borrow it.
I was like, borrow it.
He's just like in the back of the room.
Borrow it.
In the back
you
of the room.
Borrow,
he's like, borrow it. Borrow it. It was the funniest
I
thing.
I just kept yelling, borrow it, until she stopped talking and addressed how.
Wait,
weird
how do
it
they
is.
Borrow it? Do they just like exchange right there?
Yeah,
don't
just like,
borrow
hey, Levi,
somebody's
hey,
underwear.
Levi, can I have
it's
your boxers?
Weird. It is. It's weird. If you have, yeah, if you're desperate, it's okay. If you just shit your pair of underwear and you're like, dude, I just shit my pants. I need some underwear.
No, borrow it, some what underwear. It is, it, it's
but
sort of
in
like
this
Uber,
scenario
like a,
that they
like
were typing out,
sharing network except for underwear.
In this magazine scenario that they were spelling out, they were like, oh, hey, buddy, I'm
Uber.
Going to this cool sex party that I'm not really experienced with. Do you have any cool underwear that I could borrow?
Yeah, she's like, oh, it's just like borrowing a swimsuit.
He's like, no, it isn't.
It's not. You wear your underwear all day.
Yeah, you wear a swimsuit for like a day.
You don't even have a swimsuit, Zach.
I don't even own a swimsuit. That is true.
I don't
ever
think I do
either,
I don't
like
actually.
Swimming. I know how to swim. I've been in the water. I don't like swimming.
What the fuck?
Swimming is awesome.
I just don't enjoy it.
What don't you like about it? Yeah.
How do you not like swimming? I feel like that's like that's like saying you don't like breathing.
I like sitting in water, but I don't like.
No, that's so not. Like, that's kind of the opposite because you can't breathe while you swim.
So you don't like exercise?
Yeah, pretty much. Maybe I'm just a fat.
Is that
fuck,
what it is?
Is what I am.
Is that what it is? Like, I just don't like moving.
Hot tub.
Yeah.
Hot tub warrior.
Hot tub night.
Hot tub night, yeah.
Had a bad experience at a pool one time. Hot
I like
tub
sitting
night was
in
very
water.
Aggressive.
I like being wet. That doesn't bother me. I just don't like swimming. I don't like going to pools.
I just
like
love,
I don't like being
I love
in
getting
pools.
Wet.
Is it because it's?
I don't like going to pools. I think it's because I know just like how many people piss in that thing. Like including me.
Why
I'm,
do you
I'll
always
piss in it? As soon as I get into a pool, the first thing I do is piss in it.
Fuck you, you're a piece of shit.
I mean, because I know other people have done it, and like, I want to join. Listen, I know other people have pissed in this pool. I'm pissing in this pool.
Don't give in, you sheep. don't piss in the pool.
I just don't like pools. I don't like swimming. I don't
good,
like...
I'm glad you didn't come swimming with me and Jeff, because you would have pissed all over us, you freak.
Zachary also loves golden showers.
I had a friend in Catholic school who, when they got baptized, they pissed in the water.
That's awesome.
And there were people after him.
That is kind
baptized.
Of amazing.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it was just like, he told me, it's like, yeah, like, when I get in water, like, I just feel like the need to pee. And so when, like, with baptism, when it was happening, I peed.
How old was he?
He was like, I don't know, like 10. He wasn't young enough for it to be like cute, and he wasn't like old enough for it to be creepy. So, but still, other people had to get baptized in his piss water, essentially.
That's awesome.
So they got baptized.
I'm pretty sure
in
that
this
like negated
piss.
Whatever.
He might as well
fucking
just
Catholic
pissed
magic
over their
that.
Heads.
I'm pretty sure that negated whatever Catholic magic made that holy.
Yeah,
matter.
They're going to hell now. Those people that they got.
Yeah, and he ruined it for everyone else.
Yeah,
like
all those people that got baptized after him are going to hell because they didn't get a proper baptism and they have original sin still.
Is there an age limit to getting baptized?
No.
No.
I can go get baptized.
You can get
tomorrow.
Baptized tomorrow. You can get as long. You can get baptized. Like if you think you're gonna die, you can get baptized. Like by me, I could baptize you. Like
is that just
real?
Giving me a
I
bath?
Thought,
pretty much. No, like there's certain that allow basically any person to baptize you. I guess not me, since I'm not a believer. But there are certain circumstances where you can be baptized by anybody. Like, if you're going out to war the next day, you think you're going to die, you can just have a friend of yours that believes in Jesus baptize you. You're good. You're solid.
I thought you had to have, like, a priest perform some final rites or whatever.
Most of the time, yes. But in extreme circumstances, there are cases where you can get baptized by literally any Joe Schmo.
What's the line on that? What's, like, an extreme circumstance?
If you think you're going to die the next day.
The line of, like, not being
it's pretty
extreme.
Much life or death.
What if I run out of pizza rolls? Can I have a friend baptize me then?
I mean, that's...
What if...
You did just describe a life or death situation to me, so I think so, yes.
What if I just, like, have a toothache and I looked up on WebMD what's wrong with me? So... Obviously, it tells me I'm about to die.
Yeah. Well, then, hey, that's a crisis right there.
Does that work?
Yeah. I mean, look.
Oh, your tooth hurts? You can't rule out cancer.
Oh, my God.
Fuck, I always panic when I run out of pizza rolls.
Yeah.
I never run out of pizza
baptize
rolls.
Me, please.
What if you're
baptize
choking...
me in pizza rolls?
What if you're choking on a pizza roll?
Then you could get baptized by, like, I could baptize you at that circumstance.
I always love that
on a pizza roll.
I always love that joke when you see people in like movies or TV shows where they're like about to die and they're all like, "I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, made it." Because I mean, that's basically what it is, isn't it? Like, you just have to do it right at the end there.
I mean, yeah. I mean, like, well, some, it depends. Like, you know, the church is kind of arbitrary.
It doesn't matter because it's fake.
Yeah, it's fake. The church makes up whatever it is. So at certain times, yes, that's true. At other times, it wasn't. Certain beliefs think that it's graces. The so-called graces, this arbitrary word graces that gets you into heaven. We're talking back on a religion. What the fuck?
I don't really care about that. Can I get baptized on a slip and slide?
Sure. Yeah, I think you can actually. The little pool at the
that
end
would be
of the slip and slide. I think you could get baptized on that.
I want to get baptized at Water Whiz. It's this fucking water park up here.
That's basically you're getting baptized.
Like, I think
kiss,
if you have
you know?
The Pope come there and bless the pool, I think that makes it.
Oh, you mean
holy
wave his
totally
hands
it.
At it and say, "This is holy.
Yeah.
Now. This is touched by God."
Yeah.
Do you think
that's
the Pope
religion.
Pisses in it and that's what makes it holy water?
Yes.
Fucking awesome.
I'm sorry I'm talking about piss so much. I've had a few drinks. And I have a low tolerance, and I need to piss.
Is that just what happens when you drink?
Yeah, I need to piss.
He becomes obsessed
piss.
With piss.
Well, I just think about what's on my mind, and what's on my mind now is my need to pee. I can hold it.
Piss in that jar. It'll be good podcast material.
The piss in the mason jar? I drink from there.
I mean, that's half of the uses people do have for mason jars is, you know, pissing in them.
Well,
and
I'm not an animal.
In the closet.
How much would it?
I'm not an animal.
How much would it cost me for me to see this sec?
I mean,
I want to.
To be honest, $100
to pee.
Not even $100.
Not even $100.
If I'm gonna be honest, not even $100.
If you sent me $100, I would piss on the floor right now.
Yeah, dude.
Piss on the floor.
Give me $5, I'll pee somewhere.
Yeah, dude. Like, it's peeing. Like, all I have to do is like, how much does it cost to like? You know, run the
I'll even
towel
let you guys see my soft dick while it's pissing if you really
want.
Yeah,
let me chub up a little bit, though, first. I gotta chub up a little.
It's just a dick. I mean, Shane apparently is real familiar with a dick.
I'm familiar with my own dick. We go on adventures.
I mean, how much does it cost to, like, run a towel through a washer and dryer? Like, triple that. There we go. Done. I'll piss on something.
How much does nothing cost? Triple that.
Yeah. A lot.
3 times 0 is still 0, and you can fucking guarantee I'll piss for free.
Hell, you send me $5, I'll piss in Zach's mom's mouth.
Oh, please don't bring my mom into this.
That was immediate. You're just like, no.
First.
Don't. I don't like it.
Yeah.
I will piss anywhere if you just pay me the opportunity to piss in Zach's mom's mouth.
No! My mom, okay, at my birthday party, I talked to him because I thought we might record later that day. I didn't know how late we would get home. My mom and dad asked me, so is this podcast, is this something that we should be, like, listening to?
Oh, they know about it? My aunt kind of does, but I'm sure she forgot.
They know about it. I tell them when I'm recording so they don't bother me.
I don't want my aunt hearing it because she's gonna go tell my cousins about how I flipped out, like about the Jewish thing, about her man baby son and his fucking wife.
Yeah, I basically told my parents to like, I'd rather you don't listen to it.
Apparently, our parents know about it, and I told my mom she's never allowed to listen to it, and
hey,
dad
shout
apparently
out to Shane's
does
mom.
Listen to it.
Does do they?
I'm gonna pee
dad,
and
no, dad
mom,
listens
mom.
To it, and apparently he thinks it's fucking hilarious.
Oh, that's awesome. Great. We have
also that's
yes.
how he found.
I know.
That's how dad found out that I was the one that broke Stefan's arm.
Oh really? He didn't
yeah.
know that.
Yeah, he didn't know that. He's like, you
oh,
never
boy,
told me.
Oh boy, we're
that
already
he...
causing problems.
But the thing is I did tell him that, and he just doesn't pay attention. He doesn't give a fuck about anything.
That's when he grabbed Shane's arm.
He doesn't care about his children.
He grabbed Shane's arm and broke his. He's like, how do you like it?
Get your dad's opinion on what's weirder, to blow a kid or to be blown by a kid. Now we can get an actual dad's opinion on it. You should ask him.
What's your dad's name?
Our dad's name is Chad.
Chad,
what do you think?
Yeah.
Huh?
Email us.
Send an email to
hifriendspodcast@gmail.com.
It's your old friend, Smooth Jazz Giles. What would be weirder, huh? Levi's dick in your mouth. Or your dick in Levi's mouth. Buddy?
It's got real.
You know what's weird?
That's a real question you're asking somebody.
Yeah, you know what's weird is he's just going to wait until, like, Christmas, and he's just going to answer the question at, like, Christmas when everyone's around.
I hope so.
Oh, that reminds
That'd be
me
awesome.
Of one of the best moments I have ever experienced at, like, a family gathering.
Oh, yeah.
Levi probably remembers this, when my dad, at Thanksgiving dinner, admitted to wanting to abort the fuck out of Levi.
Oh, shit.
Holy shit.
That's incredible. Shit. Levi, you almost got aborted.
Aborted?
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
I was an accident, apparently.
Well, so was I.
Yeah, well, I think we all were, but.
I'm sure I was.
My parents were apparently super broke at the time, and my dad was like, yeah. I was like, oh, we can take care of this right now. And he's like, I'm glad I didn't, obviously.
I was just thinking
but,
about
this. At the time.
Well, wasn't it that, like, my dad got a vasectomy, and they didn't know that, like, it takes a couple weeks to kick in, or, you know, like,
dude, it takes a couple days to recover. How much of a trooper is your dad to get back into bed a couple days after
the man?
No, okay, I think what it was is mom was going to get her tubes tied, and then, like, she got pregnant before it could happen.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes, our parents share a lot with us.
I've always wondered, like, what would be worse, to be aborted and to never live, or to, like, know that your parents wanted to abort you. And I guess
it would be the latter, because that's the only way you would even know anything.
You wouldn't exist.
I guess it's
what is your guy? Hey, back to politics. So, what's your guy's stance on abortion?
So to answer that question, it would be way better to be aborted.
Yeah.
Because then you wouldn't understand pain and misery.
Back to politics, what's your guys' stance on abortion?
Well, I know Giles is in favor of it, and I won't get into why, because that's his story.
Because he wants to be aborted.
No, one of my girlfriends had an abortion.
Did you knock her up?
And it was before, like, when he was 16.
She just spread all that fucking baby batter all up in her fucking child.
I was 17. Yeah, I almost never used the condom, so it was 9,000% my fault.
Yeah, it was like, Giles, how old would the kid be? It'd be.
Well, I was 17 at the time. It would be. It would be like eight or nine.
Jesus.
So 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 7. Eight years old.
It'd be in second grade right now.
It would be nine this year.
I don't understand why people hate abortion so much. I mean, if only all of our problems could be fixed so easily.
Some people who hate abortions
I'm just
are okay with the death penalty.
I'm going to make a check next to the people, pro-lifers, people that we've offended. Check.
Oh, fuck them. Good.
So here's my stance on politics, I guess.
You're dumb.
So I think we should, if we are going to allow abortion, we should also allow the death penalty, if we're going to actually do it.
I'm actually
because,
like,
I don't know that those things are completely
100%. Well, like,
one's
said,
a human being
no,
who's
Giles,
lived a life and who's committed a crime, and the other one is a piece of cells and a bunch of blobs.
Like Giles said, like,
that may become
people,
alive or may not.
Some people who support the death penalty
don't support abortion.
That
is true.
So it's like, that's like a good ground, like middle ground for like two.
Okay, so I think you have your argument backwards.
So what you're saying is that pro-lifers should be anti-death penalty, is what you think.
No, I think that if we're gonna cross off two fucking
that is what you're saying.
Yeah, that is what you're saying. You're saying the vice versa. Yeah. If you think I actually have like weird reasons for believing about death penalty, and they're boring and uninteresting, so I'm not gonna talk about them.
Fucking say all it, right. Zach. You brought
okay,
it up.
Okay, do you want me to say it? It's because our prison system is flawed, and a person convicted for a crime that would get life in prison would not get their case looked at as intensely as if they were gotten a death sentence. So if we set up a hypothetical situation where a person gets gets charged of a crime that is worthy of the death penalty or life in prison, he is more likely to get his case looked at and acquitted if he gets the death penalty, if he's in a death penalty state.
You know
Doesn't
what
it
I don't
feel better
understand?
To have fired that Chekhov's gun?
You know what I don't understand?
What?
I don't understand why other people dying bothers anybody.
That's a weird psychotic thing you just said.
It's not really.
No,
I mean,
like,
wait, what
really?
Do you mean? Like, do you mean like strangers or like?
Like we've
strangers.
Like, oh, okay. Then well, never yeah. mind. Then that's not weird.
Like, no, straight. Yeah, about
it, with like celebrities.
Giles,
like,
an injustice well, anywhere is an injustice everywhere. Okay.
Yeah.
No, it's like,
no
oh,
one man
you can't
is an
kill
island.
A baby.
Do
no,
not ask for whom not, the bell not, tolls because it tolls for thee.
You're not ever going to fucking meet
okay,
the baby
fucking
that's going to get
Sandman.
That's going to get coat hangered. You're not going to meet the guy that's getting the chair. Why do you give a shit? Sip your coffee and shut the fuck up and get a hobby.
I have a friend who
Well,
who's
so
a
the
death penalty.
Death penalty thing is kind of a big one because there have been a lot of people that have been killed who were innocent.
Were innocent.
Oh that's yeah, well I mean that's true, but in the next life they'll try again and they'll be more careful.
That's before the modern.
So wait, you don't believe in religion but you're all about the fucking reincarnation?
Well, whatever happens. I mean, we weren't doing. Do you remember before you were born?
That's what I think.
Yeah,
of
I've
all
heard
the
argument. Yeah.
Do you remember what you were like before you were born?
I remember.
Okay, good. It's gonna be exactly like
I
that.
I do.
After you die.
I had so
exactly.
many past lives, you guys. I was BB King, and also I was Cleopatra.
I was.
I was BBC.
I was Stevie Wonder.
Yeah, you ever notice how people aren't like everyone was someone famous and cool? No one was just like, I don't know. I looked into my past lives. I was some fucking dirt farmer that got kicked in the head by a mule.
I was an illiterate farmer in China who died from a horse kicking me in the head. That's what I was in a past life.
I was my dad in the past life. Like, what if you are your dad, and then you have a baby, and your soul gets
That's
passed on to the
what
baby?
It is.
No,
like,
your soul gets
your
passed
DNA.
On. Your soul gets passed on to the baby, and then you just like your dad is an empty shell walking around. Like he just like you just keep like when I
Giles,
have a baby,
like
I will
my
become
dad.
My baby.
No. How do you explain three sons, Giles? How do you explain multiple children yeah. if that's the case? If that were the case,
am I the only one here who's played Dark Souls?
Whoever's the favorite. Whoever's the favorite.
The favorite gets the soul. The favorite
that
gets
yeah.
the soul.
I have the soul shame.
So who gets the
yeah,
soul
probably.
In the Lancaster family?
You can see
by the way. Because I definitely
dance.
Know it's Giles in the Ellis family gets the soul, and it's me in my family that gets the soul.
I don't know if I.
Do
I
you
don't know if I'm my dad's
you
favorite.
You think one of your other pill brothers?
You watch your mouth. I don't think I'm my dad's favorite because I wasn't as cool as my other brothers.
Well, I mean, you did draw that sick picture of Osama bin Laden mutilated in the bank vault, so that gives you
yeah.
some brownie points right there.
But I'm cooler now.
So who in the Lancaster family got your dad's soul?
Levi.
Me.
Levi's
That's
the
like
family.
Not even a...
The one that wanted to... The not one that was almost contest. Aborted gets the soul?
Yeah, well, yeah, they yeah. felt really guilty
he's
about it.
He's compensating.
Like, we should probably,
exactly.
You know.
Yeah, he's overcompensating. Is it you, Zach?
Yeah, I get the soul. I'm way better than my
oh,
sisters.
Oh, fuck that, dude. One of your hot-ass sisters has to have the soul.
Is
your
Zach's
dad has
super
to.
Hot?
Zach.
Your dad,
Zach, is your
yeah.
sister hot?
He's
I mean,
he
listen, has, I'm not going to say. I'm not going to say because that's weird.
He has two sisters, and they're dope.
You're dope.
Fucking, your dad has to
this
know that his
like,
daughters are banging.
This is like,
He must look at his daughter's
like
child. You
is
girls
just basically
are slamming.
The slam
you
zone.
Bring friends over and they go, oh my god, your sister's so hot. He's like, shut up.
Yeah.
Shut up, I don't want to hear that.
Your sisters are hot.
Your
sisters
are
hot,
Zach?
You know what you are going to hear? You're going to hear me banging her on your fucking bed.
Yeah, good luck. Good luck. They have way more standards than you.
Are you kidding? Okay, Zach, one of your sister's boyfriend is a fat chud. So don't.
Actually, she broke up with him. She's single now, so you have a chance.
Are you shitty? Can you please direct her to my Facebook?
There's no way. I mean,
you had an argument with yourself about how you're a fucking terrible person?
She thought that, no, when I introduced Giles to her, she thought Giles is my boyfriend. I don't think Giles has much as a shot.
Well, no. Yeah, she thought, but she was also disappointed.
That's what Giles
Because she was banging some fat, out-of-breath piece of shit. And look at me, I am in the prime of my life.
Oh, that's sad. Your Facebook photo literally says the word trash on it. So.
No, it says dumpster fire.
Whatever. I'm gonna friend request her once we sign off.
Go for it.
You'll see. I'm gonna message her a picture of my dick once I sign off.
Yeah, would you be mad?
Like, she doesn't even know
I
me,
wouldn't
but,
be mad.
You know,
You'd be
I just want her to know.
I'd basically be one step closer to fucking you. If you
what? If I'm banging your sister.
I mean, you're banging.
See, Zach doesn't.
Think about
Zach
that.
Think
whenever
it's
you're
hot unless
sister,
you're his brother-in-law.
Listen, if you ever bang my sister, you're just banging half of me. So think of that. Maybe that'll get you hard.
Oh, you're right. And you know what? What would make it even closer? I would always be fucking your sister in the ass, Zach.
All
right.
I don't.
Right in
I
the
regret
ass.
Saying the last sentence.
Right in the ass.
I regret. I take it back.
Right in her dirty, dirty. Very dirty.
You know what? You know, as soon as you friend request her, I'm going to show her this clip of the podcast. How
about
that? See how good your chances go up.
Girls like a dominant
Zach,
male.
What would you do if she just got super excited about it? She's just like, yes.
Yes. Girls love a dom. Well, what does she want? A submissive cunt? A submissive asshole dude is the same as a 600-pound woman.
Why
not interesting.
Okay. I was waiting for
how
I was waiting
correlated?
For you to finish that thought.
Yeah.
Because a submissive guy, nobody wants a submissive guy, and nobody wants a 600-pound girl.
Why is
I'm
the
right.
dude 600
no,
pounds?
Right. Huh?
Said, why is the dude 600 pounds?
No, girl.
The girl 600 pounds. The submissive
oh,
guy. This
I
is
guess.
A weird analogy.
Guys, everybody
you know,
wants,
okay.
everybody
yeah,
wants guys
the
for their,
analogy.
Everybody wants guys for their personality. Guys, people want guys for their personality, and guys want girls for their looks. And a submissive attitude is the same as a 600-pound beast.
Wait, so you've never been turned off by a girl for being a just total bitch?
No.
No, Giles, you should watch a movie called Shallow Hal.
I know that stupid fucking gay-ass Adam Sandler movie.
It's a Jack Black movie, Mister.
It's Adam Sandler, isn't it?
It's Jack no. Black, dude. Oh. So you haven't seen it, you piece of shit.
I have.
No, you haven't. Fucking.
It's
Jack
Adam Black
Sandler
is the
plays
same
his
as Adam
sister,
Sandler.
Plays his own sister yeah. as his own self, and then he sees women. He sees women who they are inside, and then he gets a bunch of his comedian friends and tries to sell Pepto-Bismol. So
no, we were.
That's Shallow Hal.
We talked about Shallow Hal before, where I was like, once I found out she was fat and gross, even yeah. though I made a connection with her, I would just be like, all right, see you later.
Yeah, but
Charles, I thought you said
goodbye.
That you didn't see anything as a fucking grenade that you could dive on.
Yeah, I would fuck him, but I'm not going to bring you around my family and be embarrassed that you can't stop shoving Twinkies up your ass. You fat bitch, close your fucking mouth. I'll bang you, yeah, because that's just... cream coming
you
out
know
of my dick.
My favorite
dick,
part of Shallow
very
Hal
used...
was? The part where he huh? pretends to be a substitute teacher and teaches a bunch of kids how to play music. That was my favorite part of Shallow Hal.
Yeah.
And then he's addicted to heroin while he's trying to shoot a movie in fucking Korea.
And then he finds Satan's tooth and turns it into a guitar pick and makes a
Are you describing High School Musical?
Brings it back to New York.
Are you describing not High School Musical? What is band? What is it? What you... With Jack Black?
Just High School Musical. The one where Jack Black teaches Zac Efron the meaning of high school.
What? Oh, School of Rock. Yeah, that's what it was.
Describing a lot of Jack Black movies. If you don't get the bit, if you're not quite understanding the bit, I described a bunch of Adam Sandler movies and then a bunch of Jack Black movies. That's what I did.
Oh, really?
I got High School Musical.
Yeah,
that featured.
And then
none
one
of
his brothers is retarded, and there's an apple.
Yeah, I love the apple. I love when the apple comes in. I'm gonna audition for the apple in the second one.
What, in High School Musical 2? You're gonna audition for the apple?
Yeah. Oh my god. I am so stupid today. I can't even, like, make a regular thought. I think laughing too hard at Shane coddling a mold of his own dick.
Dude,
just really,
you
like,
guys keep
turned...
trying to make me feel bad about this. I will never feel bad about this. Me and
That's
my
because
dick
you're gay,
are gonna
Shane.
Be best friends. I'm gonna dress him up in a little Christmas sweater.
Shane, are you squinting right now?
Levi, would you be upset if, like, Shane brought a mold of his dick around to, like, Christmas parties?
I am expecting to see a mold of Shane's dick by the next podcast recording is what I am. That's what I want. All right.
That could be our first.
Are you always
going to
be disturbed when it's the size of a fucking schnauzer?
I hope so.
Yeah, dude.
Not because my dick's that big, just because I'm going to blow it up. It's not enough to just have a mold of my regular dick. I want it to be
inflatable.
Like baby sized, so I can coddle it and put it in a fucking.
Oh, like the size of a baby,
like a purse,
not the size of a baby's dick. Okay, I thought you said baby size. You might as well have said fun sized. I think you're getting across the wrong words there.
Nope, we put it in a baby Bjorn, carry it around.
All right, I think we should wrap up. It's about that time. You can follow us on iTunes. We're on iTunes. Any place where you can find podcasts. You can email us at highfriendspodcast@gmail.com. We have a Facebook.
Highfriendspodcast@gmail.com.
Yeah. Highfriendspodcast.
Highfriendspodcast@gmail.com.
You can follow us on Facebook. You just have to Google High Friends. It'll be the one where there are a ton of messages from Middle Eastern people, and then Giles and Levi are just saying random bullshit to them and telling them to, like, basically burn
Okay, they can't see
like,
that.
You guys are
mostly
spiraling
Levi.
Down.
I do not
deep,
say
deep,
that.
Deep
that is
well, you did say that you were in hell one time, okay?
I said I was Satan.
Okay.
And that is completely different.
All right. But you
okay, like... Regular visitors can't see that. Those were like private messages sent to us.
Yeah.
Oh, they can't. Zach. People can't see those. Only us.
No.
No.
Oh, that's a shame.
We could do screen capture.
Yeah. We're also on YouTube. Our first episode is on SoundCloud. If you care.
Fuck SoundCloud. No, it's not.
Giles is trying to erase SoundCloud from existence.
Yeah, it's not on there. Fuck that. SoundCloud sucks.
I think that's everything.
All right.
All right, bye, friends.
So, well, to my one listener, I'm back, baby.
Yeah, I'm Zach Price.
I'm Levi Lancaster.
I'm Shane Lancaster.
And I don't really know anymore. Bye, friends.
Bye, friends.
Bye, friends.